अपने बच्चे को कोविड-19 से बहुत बीमार पड़ने से बचाएं। 5 साल और बड़े बच्चों को अब कोविड-19 टीका लगाया जा सकता है और कई के लिए अब दूसरी खुराक का समय होगा। कोई सवाल होने पर भरोसेमंद पेशवर से बात करें या covid19.act.gov.au/vaccinechildren पर जाएं। अनुवाद और द्विभाषीय सेवा को 131450 पर कॉल कर सकते हैं।
अपने बच्चे को कोविड-19 की शदीद बीमारी से महफूज रखें। अब 5 साल और उससे ज्यादा उम्र के बच्चे कोविड-19 वैक्सीन लगवा सकते हैं और कई बच्चों के लिए अब वैक्सीन की दूसरी डोज का वक्त होगा। अगर आपका कोई सवाल हो तो अपने भरोसे के तिब्बी माहिर से बात करें या covid19.act.gov.au/vaccinechildren देखें। आप 131450 पर तहरीरी और जबानी तर्जुमे की सर्विस को भी कॉल कर सकते हैं।
एसीटी देसी पे हर हफ्ते मैं कोशिश करता हूँ कि कुछ नया आपके लिए लेके आऊँ। और इस बार जब मैंने ये शो बनाने के बारे में सोचा तो मैंने कुछ हफ्ते पहले एक ऐसे शो की बात की थी जिसमें आप इंडिया का एक रूप नहीं पूरी तरह से इंडिया को देख सकते हैं ऑस्ट्रेलिया में, कैनबरा में स्पेशली। और ये शो हर साल ऑर्गेनाइज किया जाता है। पिछले साल नहीं हो पाया था क्योंकि कोविड का रीजन था, और लेकिन इस बार जो कहते हैं ना पिछली बार की जो हमने एनर्जी बचा के रखी थी वो इस बार हम लेके आ रहे हैं। तो जिस शो की मैं बात कर रहा हूँ उसका नाम है ऑज इंडिया शो और उसको ऑर्गेनाइज करती है फिन एक्ट। आप सब जानते होंगे लेकिन थोड़ा और अच्छे से जानते हैं कि ये क्या एसोसिएशन है, ये क्या शो है और इसमें हम क्या एक्सपेक्ट कर सकते हैं। तो आज मेरे साथ इसके ऊपर बात करने के लिए मेरे साथ हैं मिस्टर शांति रेड्डी जो प्रेसिडेंट है फिन एक्ट के, और आज वो मेरे साथ कुछ कैजुअल या कैंडिड डिस्कशन जैसे मैं अपने शो में हमेशा करता हूँ कुछ करेंगे। हम जानेंगे उनके बारे में, उस एसोसिएशन के बारे में, इस शो के बारे में और कुछ अच्छे अच्छे गाने भी प्ले करेंगे। हो सकता है इस बार मल्टी लैंग्वेज सॉन्ग आप सुने एसीटी देसी पे, बिकॉज शांति जी हमारे साथ है और एसीटी देसी पे पहली बार ऐसा नहीं होगा कि हम डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस के सॉन्ग सुनेंगे। तो चलिए आइए शो को स्टार्ट करते हैं और वेलकम करते हैं हमारे आज के गेस्ट मिस्टर शांति रेड्डी का। वेलकम सर।
विकास जी नमस्ते, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आपने बुलाया, ये मौका दिया, थैंक यू वेरी मच।
नो प्रॉब्लम सर, ऑलवेज वेलकम। वो कहते हैं ना कि जब टाइम सही होता है तब लोग इंसान मिलते हैं, और आई थिंक ये कोविड के बाद एक ऐसा टाइम है जब हम सब लोग वेट कर रहे थे कुछ ऐसी चीजों के होने की, और अब आप देख भी रहे होंगे कि एक के बाद एक शोज हो रहे हैं, लेकिन ये एक शो खास है। तो शो पे तो हम जाएंगे लेकिन पहले हम जानना चाहेंगे कुछ आपके बारे में। Who is शांति रेड्डी? थोड़ा सा इंट्रोडक्शन दीजिए हमारे ऑडियंस और लिसनर्स को जो आपको सुन रहे हैं एसीटी देसी पे।
जी हाँ बिल्कुल, तो मेरा पूरा नाम है विकास जी शांति स्वरूप रेड्डी। आई कम फ्रॉम हैदराबाद, सो आई केम हियर इन 1998, सो इट्स अबाउट 24 इयर्स अगो माइग्रेटेड। सो आई केम ऑन स्किल माइग्रेशन वीजा एंड आई हैव बीन इन कैनबरा सिंस देन। I have two boys. They're both grown up. They're both in Sydney. So it's me and my wife in Canberra now. And it's a lovely city. And we had a great time in 25 years. And we're still, all my family is back in India.
Right.
And of course, all my friends and all of that. So it's the best of both worlds to me, is that we don't have to choose, So yeah, that's about me, Vikash ji.
Right. So ye to aapne wo introduction diya jo normally interview mein log dete hain. शांति रेड्डी जो यहाँ पे आए थे जब 96 में यहाँ पे आए थे, सो व्हाट ब्रॉट यू हियर फ्रॉम हैदराबाद? आई मीन आर यू वर यू देयर फॉर एजुकेशन?
नो जी, विकास जी ऐसा हुआ है, तो ये जैसे आपने पहले शुरुआत आपके इंट्रोडक्शन में बताए थे, जब टाइम आता है तो हो जाते हैं चेंज। तो ऐसा हुआ मेरे साथ कि मैंने एक्चुअली इसरो में साइंटिस्ट से काम कर रहा था इंडिया में। तो आई ज्वाइंड इसरो इन लेट 80s, सो आई वर्क देयर फॉर 10 ईयर्स। काफी अच्छा काम किया मैंने इंडियन स्पेस रिसर्च ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में। मेरा एक स्पेशलाइजेशन है, एक्चुअली मैंने पीएचडी किया जियोलॉजी में और रिमोट सेंसिंग। ठीक है, तो रिमोट सेंसिंग यानी यू टेक पिक्चर्स फ्रॉम सैटेलाइट्स, जो ऑर्बिटिंग सैटेलाइट्स होते हैं उन पे कैमराज होते हैं, अलग अलग टाइप्स के कैमराज होते हैं। तो वो जो घूमते हैं तो दे'ल कैप्चर पिक्चर्स, सो वी आई स्पेशलाइज एनालाइजिंग दैट to look at the rocks, to look at the water, look at all the environmental features uspe. So काफी अच्छा field है, really enjoyed. I did PhD, मैं अमेरिका भी गया था, वहाँ पढ़ा था, PhD किया, आ गया तो इसरो में मुझे अच्छा काम मिला। तो मैंने काफी enjoy किया 10 साल। तो ऐसा हुआ कि 10 साल में because of geology, हम लोग जब मैंने geology पढ़ा था, ऑस्ट्रेलिया में काफी कुछ geology है आप जानते ही हैं। सो ऑस्ट्रेलिया का जो पूरा कंट्री का जो है बेस है एक्चुअली माइनिंग इंडस्ट्री है आप जानते हैं, इसमें यहाँ पे काफ़ी अच्छा डिपॉजिट्स हैं। तो हम लोग जब जियोलॉजी पढ़ते थे तो बीएससी में भी मास्टर्स में भी, तो कई नाम हैं, तो हम कुछ ज़्यादा मतलब एज अ जियोलॉजिस्ट वी हैव दैट पैशन ऑस्ट्रेलिया से कनेक्शन।
जियोलॉजी की जब आप बात करते हैं तो कोई कुछ आपने जेम्स वगैरह फाइंड किए? यहाँ पे गोल्ड रश भी होता है, डायमंड रश भी होता है, कुछ वर यू एबल टू फाइंड एनीथिंग?
मैंने नहीं किया, लेकिन हम लोग जब इंडिया में काम कर रहे थे, वी आर एबल टू डिटेक्ट फ्रॉम स्पेस किम्बरलाइट पाइप। द किम्बरलाइट जो होती है पाइप होता है जो उसमें डायमंड्स मिलते हैं।
मैं वापस आता हूँ उस बात पे जो आपने कहा था कि जहाँ पे आपको डायमंड आपने जियो सैटेलाइट से सेंस किया था, तो वो सीक्रेट अभी तक आपने बताया किसी को, ये अपने पास ही रखा हुआ है कि बाद में?
नहीं, ये कोई सीक्रेट नहीं, ये कोई सीक्रेट नहीं। This discovery of deposits is, it takes quite a long period of time and a lot of investment time and something, sometimes you spend a lot of time and money, it doesn't work out, the deposit doesn't prove to be economical.
तो शांति जी के तो शांति जी की लाइफ एक डिस्कवरी है, वो खुद भी डिस्कवरी करते रहते हैं, तो उनकी लाइफ की डिस्कवरी को और जानेंगे, लेकिन एक छोटे से ब्रेक के बाद आप हैं मेरे यानी आपके अपने देसी आज विकास के साथ, और ये है एसीटी देसी जो आता है हर शुक्रवार रात 8:30 इन कैनबरा और 3 इन इंडिया ओनली ऑन 2XXFM 98.3 पीपल पावर रेडियो। नमस्ते, सलाम, सत श्री अकाल, वणक्कम, केम छो। आप जैसे जैसे यू नो एवरीवन हु कम्स यू नो एज एन इमिग्रेंट यू नो हु कम्स ओवर हियर एंड दे हैव देयर ओन जर्नी दे हैव देयर ओन यू नो ट्रायल्स एंड ट्रिबुलेशंस एंड विंस एंड लॉसेस आपको अगर एनकैप्सुलेट करना हो कि आपकी जर्नी फॉर द पास्ट 24 ऑड इयर्स जो आप हैं यहां पे फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग टू द टाइम दैट यू आर इन राइट नाउ कुछ ऐसी चीज है जो आपको याद आती है पुराने टाइम में जब आप आए थे और यू नो अभी भी याद करते हैं उस टाइम
काफी कुछ है जी ये तो आपको एक घंटे का प्रोग्राम है आपको एक दिन का प्रोग्राम बनाना पड़ेगा
कोई एक चीज बताइए जो आपने यू नो कहते ना कि एक मुश्किल आई यू ओवरकेम एंड देन यू फेल्ट लाइक वाओ लाइक आई हैव डन इट कोई एक चीज ऐसे याद आ रही हो आपको
नहीं काफी काफी चीजें हैं जो आई कैन स्टिल रिमेम्बर द डे वी लैंडेड यू नो एज यू नो यू आल्सो केम इन 2019 एज एन इमिग्रेंट व्हेन यू लैंड हियर वी हैड नो relatives, no family, right? You come here. I had a 4-year-old son, and it is difficult, right? I mean, despite we have all of the best facilities in the world, and it's a good country, great country. That, you know, when you come here, you need. We were expecting our second child, so we needed medical treatment. So it's it takes a while to get the cards and all of that, and then right. find a job. So luckily, in my case, we had first 1 year was really, it's like a mix, right? Roller coaster. Luckily, I was able to find a job within less than a month, really. And I was really fortunate to find a job in my own field with the Australian Centre for Remote Sensing. So I used to work in India, National Centre for Remote Sensing in India. Now I came to Australia, Australian Centre for Remote Sensing. I continued my job, and they actually valued my work very much. Maine acha kaam kiya, or in fact, I was given a watch. My first year, I finished a project. I was given a watch. I still have that watch. It still works, right? Yes. That was a good side of the thing. The tough time thing is that, you know, we had our second child, Sanju. He's now 24. He's a lovely kid. We had to, because we didn't have a lot of friends, and also, you know, we had to look after two kids, and, you know, I was just, even my wife couldn't drive, all those practical things, right, it's challenging, I wouldn't say, you know, that sometimes you go through very tough times, but we luckily had a job that was a good thing, but then the support, family support, so it took us to get my mother-in-law to here at 6 months, so the first 6 months were really tough to, you know, look after the work and two kids and then all that sort of thing. But that's a very good beginning, and we have very fond memories.
Shanti ji, coming back, aapne jahan pe baat chodi ki, the journey has been wonderful. You know, everyone faces those kind of situation, like we also felt a lot of things. And then, you know, when you pass all those things and then you come out with smile, you know, it makes it worthwhile making all those challenging days. You know, it's always, you remember those challenges, but at the end of it, you remember, you know, how you came out of it, and then you celebrate that feeling. You know, that's what it is, right? So, chaliye, jab aap aaye the, tab to bahut kam Indians honge. You know, abhi bhi kuch kehte hain ki, I think around how many, 11,000, 12,000 Indians are there in Canberra?
At the time, no, lot less.
No, not right. The time. Right now, it's around.
Right now, there are about 2016 ka ABS statistics are about 15,000, but yeah. Since 2016, as you know, I think my estimate is around 20,000. At least 5,000 people would have moved in. Quite a few people coming in because of the job market here is very strong. Yeah. So I think my estimate is that around 20,000 people.
So what difference, what couple of differences that you see in the time that you've been here in Canberra all along, when you came in, you know, not many people, you know, who look similar, who, you know, who have affinity towards, when you look around, they were a different kind, right? It's a little alienated feeling, but, you know, moving from time and 24 years ago and now, what's the key difference that you see, and what's the same thing that you still feel, which you felt in 24 years?
What's the key difference? I think the differences are huge, right? I can tell you a couple of things. It used to be much more quieter city, a lot more quieter than now it is. I remember, you know, everything by 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, literally city center, you would not see anyone, right? I'm not kidding. Literally, you will not see a single person walking on the street. The roads are empty, 6 o'clock. And the house prices, you won't believe, every housing around Canberra, you know, in the north side, at least I know I lived all along in the north side, Belconnen area, 110, 105K, you get a 3-bedroom house, a big block, right? Scullion, we used to right. cook and all of that. A good house would cost, you know, Bruce was like a very expensive, that was like 250, 280, 300, right? Wow. So the housing market was very, very, you know, very affordable, I should say. Jobs were, again, you know, quite plenty, but again, the population was a lot less, you know, not only just Indian, but in general, Canberra population would have been, you know, definitely a lot less. And petrol was 85 cents. Can I say that, Vikaji?
Yeah.
Both important point. Petrol was 85 cents. I've had it for a couple of years. I paid nowhere I'm paying $2.20. So you can imagine.
If you compare that with the housing as well, $110,000 for a house is the median price right now is $1 million. So like you have added one.
Exactly, 10 times, right?
Yeah.
The salaries have gone up 3 times, right? I can tell you the salaries have gone up 3 times, whereas the houses, my salary has gone up 3 times. My house, you know, the houses have gone up in general 10 times, right? As you just said, $1 million. So those things, I think some of them are really, Canberra is not unique in that sense. This is a worldwide phenomenon, all of Australia. But even in India, I know, you know, a lot of my property, my ancestral property in India, when I left, it was not much. Now it is quite a bit. I cannot, you know, I have to go and pay attention to it. So that's a worldwide thing. I think that happened all over 25 years, I guess.
But that is what you talked about, Canberra. I'm more interested in Indian, you know, population that has grown in the past 24 years.
What is
still the same that you feel with the Indian people? And what has changed in the past 24 years, if you have seen?
Yeah.
जो मुझे जुनून छे ख्वाब छे बावरा खेल छा नीनाव छे जगावे केटलू सतावे हाय रे आधुनिकी
interested in Indian, you know, population that has grown in the past 24 years.
What is
still the same that you feel with the Indian people? And what has changed in the past 24 years, if you have seen?
Yeah. Look, I think that's a good question, Vikaji. So, us time mein hum log dekhte the, dhoondte hai kahin pe bhi. Koi Indian mil gaya to jaake, hello ji, kahan se hai aap? Matlab, smile se baat karte. Because there were so few of them, right? You know, I remember Telugu people. You know, one day I ran into a guy who happens to be a Telugu guy, but also from the same district. Mm. Like, this time, just like, you know, you found the best thing in the world, right? It was so joyous. We just go and hug and say, hey, why can't say all of that? And so obviously we had a lot less Indians, but But we used to actually meet in friends' houses. That's all it was, right? You know, there was like 20 families, so we just meet someone else. Right. And that's how we used to have our annual events and festivals, right? We used to celebrate festivals. Of course, now, you know, the Telugu community is so big. Every, you know, we have so many Indian groups. Not only that, the population has gone up, but actually the most interesting is the affluency and the enterprising nature of Indians. I'm so impressed. I'm really impressed that because you know, you're in the media, you meet many people, so you'll know more about that there are so successful people from Indian background in their diaspora, business chala rahe hain, companies chala rahe hain, or all sort of things, right? You talk about it, we have every field, right? At the time, if you go and find an electrician, you will never get an electrician right. in our community, whereas now you have, you know, tens and twenties or even hundreds of electricians and every field. I'm just using this as an example.
Right.
You know, you talk about doctors, professionals, IT guys, IT to hai hai, or even
every field. Do you my answer me this and answer this honestly. When you said that, you know, way back in, you know, when you were just very new in this and then you would see couple of people around and then you would reach out to them or they would reach out to you and smile and talk to you and oh, where are you from?
Yes.
Now, do you feel the same kind of connection in nowadays time when you see someone who looks familiar? Would they like, you know, look, I mean, why I'm asking this is because it's a general, you know, thing that is happening around. And Neighbors Day was last week. And you know, we talk about neighbors. Do you know your neighbor around? And you know, all those kind of things. But India mein jaise hum karte hain ki, you know, koi bhi milta hai to, you know, baat koi na koi kisi ko janta hi hota hai ya kahin dukaan mein mil jaye to baat ho jati hai. But kya aapko aisa, matlab mujhe aisa feel hota hai ki we don't connect or we don't, you know, we don't, when we see each other, like who looks like an Indian or maybe from the subcontinent, not really Indian, but say Pakistani or Bangladeshi or Nepali, for example. We don't acknowledge much. Do you think that's there?
You're probably right. I think what happens is, again, you're probably right. In the sense, we acknowledge, we smile. At least I come across anyone, I smile. Not doesn't have to be Indian diaspora, anyone. You know, it's a friendly thing.
Particularly like for Indian, I'm saying, I mean, people who look familiar, say, oh, maybe he's an Indian guy or maybe is an Indian girl, or maybe they have been here for so long, but they are from India. Like, you know, so when you see someone, they say, oh, you would stop and say hello and then say, oh, you know, how long have you been here? What have you been doing? You know, all that stuff. Is there a missing link somewhere?
No, I don't think so. People still do that. I still do that. And I don't think we should just, I do that to everyone, right? I don't do that to Indian or anyone. I mean, obviously I don't stop people and do this, but, you know, I'm standing next to someone in the line, you know, I just went to chemist shop. You know, when you strike a conversation, we just say, hello, where are you from? And the good thing, and you, because you have dekha hoga, Canberra mein, we have people from 180 countries, right?
Right.
Not counting the diplomats community. We have diplomats from all over the world, right? But, you know, so we have migrants from, you know, more than 100 countries. And we see people from all kind of backgrounds, right? You know, often we sometimes mistaken and we go and say, you know, well, are you from Sri Lanka? They say, no, I'm from India, right? Or you say, oh, you're from India? They say, no, I'm from Sri Lanka. Then it often happens, those sort of things.
Right, right.
So but that's the beauty of Canberra, right? I mean, it's just such a small place, but it's so big as well. To me, it's both. It's small, but it's big, actually. You have people,
correct.
You know, I can go to and have dinner of, you know, South American, Peruvian. There are friends from that, you know, you can eat the native, you know, South American dinner or Africans, right? We have such a vibrant African community,
right.
And we have Asian community. Of course, we have European community. So, so it's a lovely thing to me, and it's always a good thing to go and say hello to people.
Right.
You know, not everyone is, you know, that sort of it's an individual.
Friendly, there's also personal nature as well for some people.
Yeah, my kids, for example. It comes with the age as well, at my age, I have no hesitation. I used to be. My kids, for example, they don't talk to anyone. Even they're standing next to someone in line,
right.
They're on the phone, right? And they think
it's a global phenomenon, I guess. It's like with everyone in new generation, they're like very personal and private. Anyway, go on to the days. तो ये जो हम आज बात कर रहे हैं, मिस्टर शांति रेड्डी से, और अभी तक हम जान रहे थे उनके एक्सपीरियंसेस और कैसे कैनबरा चेंज हुआ है इतने टाइम से. और इस सॉन्ग के बाद हम जानेंगे कि एक ऐसी कनेक्टिंग एसोसिएशन है या एक ऐसी बॉडी है जिनके वो प्रेसिडेंट है, और उस बॉडी के बारे में जानेंगे, और जिस इवेंट के बारे में मैंने आपसे इनिशियली बात की थी उसके बारे में भी हम जानेंगे. लेकिन एक छोटे से ब्रेक के बाद, कहीं जाइएगा नहीं, मैं अभी आया और यूं आया. अभी तक तो हम बात कर रहे थे कि यू नो इंडियंस और यू नो कैनबरा में किस तरह से इवॉल्व हुए हैं और हाउ थिंग्स हैव ग्रोन एंड हाउ पीपल पर्सनली एंड यूजुअली आल्सो बिहेव. बट अभी हम पहुंचते हैं उस एसोसिएशन के बारे में बात करने के लिए जिसके आप प्रेसिडेंट हैं, फिन एक्ट. फिन एक्ट के बारे में थोड़ा सा मुझे बताइए, एक तो ये फिन एक्ट का मतलब क्या है और ये कैसे जुड़ी है आप. मुझे जो लगता है वो फाइनेंस रिलेटेड और एसीटी है, तो क्या है फिनैक्ट के बारे में थोड़ा बताइए।
जरूर विकास जी, तो फिनैक्ट है फेडरेशन ऑफ इंडियन एसोसिएशन ऑफ एसीटी। तो इसका थोड़ा हिस्ट्री बताऊंगा मैं आपको। दिस वॉज नॉट एन एक्सीडेंट, इट वॉज एक्चुअली डिजाइन बाय पर्पस। सो एट द टाइम, दिस इज बैक इन 2010, डिस्कशन स्टार्टेड। So it was time we had a high commissioner from India. So she actually initiated this, and also with ACT chief minister, I believe. So eventually that then there was a need. They felt at the time, them and the community felt that there is a need to actually bring all these different groups under one umbrella. So because to give a not necessarily single voice, but actually a united voice, right? There's a difference between a single voice and a united voice.
Very difficult to get a single voice anyway.
No. And we should not, right? In my view, they should not. It's a dictatorial, right?
Yeah.
Whereas a united voice is that you actually listen and then we communicate. So they needed a united voice from the community. Both that's, as you know, Vikaji, it's very important for a policymaker, for a decision maker in the government, to hear the views, collective views, in a productive in a manner. So that's the role FINACT has been doing over the years. And a credit to my past presidents, they have done a great job. So it's FINACT has been there. So as I said, it's initiated by those different stakeholders, and they continue to be very important stakeholders, both ACT government, but also the High Commission of India, but also federal representatives, the federal members. They're all very actively involved. Aapne dekha hoga hamara Facebook page mein hamara event ho raha hai, so everybody come forward has done that. Right. We have a very respectable position, and that comes from the collective goodness of the, it's not me, it's not Shanti Reddy, right? I come and go. We have 5-6 presidents now. They will come and go. It's the voice, the united voice of the community. And you know, the community has been very influential as well. So it is getting that attention as well. So so it's basically its role is to represent the needs and aspirations of the Canberra's Indian diaspora, not just Canberra, but in the surrounding region. We have quite a few people now in the surrounding ACT region, whether the in the New South Wales suburbs around Canberra, including Queanbeyan. So it's been doing that in the last 10 years. In fact, this we are actually, because you will come back and have aapse fir se baat karenge, hamara 10 saal ke jo hai, 10-year celebration we're going to do after All India Fair. We're going to do it. It's going to be a slightly different event, but we will be celebrating 10 years. So we formed that 2011-12 there. Jacob Wadaketudu was the first president of FINACT. And in fact, we are a very broad church. You will see we have our annual reports on our website. You can go and read. There's a nice history captured in there.
So, sir, mujhe ye bataiye ki FINACT mein aapne bola ki there like was made or was, you know, organized as an association, as an umbrella body to represent as a united voice. How many associations were there when it started, and how many associations are there right now under the umbrella?
So there were obviously, as a new body, there were a handful at the time, not many, and also there were several joints. At the moment, I can tell you now, as of now, there are 31 organizations.
And how many associations and organizations do you think are there in Canberra which are represented as Indian or, you know, organization or association? How approximately?
There are quite a few, but none like FINACT, right? FINACT actually is a more grassroots.
No, as in like you like, what I'm trying to understand is FINACT is like a body that represents a united voice for all the association that comes under it, right? What I'm trying to understand is that it's around 25,000 people or 20,000 people here of Indian origin. And then we have our own diverse culture of, you know, more than 25 states and union territories and 22 official languages and beyond. So how many do you have a fair idea of how many small, big associations like from Punjab, Madras, Tamil Nadu, Telugu, or Gujarati association, or, you know, how many association as a number, just a number issue?
31. They're all part of FINACT, right? So we have two Punjab based associations in there. We have 3 Telugu based associations. They're all members of FINACT.
So, right. So you're saying that there are 31 different association represented by Indians. That's the number. And that are all part of FINACT.
No, FINACT, I'm saying, is FINACT has 31 member associations. Okay. And they come from different parts of, they represent different parts of India. And yeah. Some of them are, not all of them are state-based. Most of them are state-based, but some of them are based on some passion, right? Whether it's a women's issue. So we have few of them based on women's needs and women's. So they're all members of FINACT. So if you're talking about outside of FINACT, obviously there are organizations outside of FINACT. It is better you hear about this from others, but yeah, obviously Indian diaspora is quite a big, right? And we are a broad church, as I said, we work with them very well. Like we have IAC, is there, India, Australia, you know, association. So there are quite a few of them. There's a GoPio, there's a MAC, there's a few, quite a few others. So we are friends. We have, you know, there's no, because end of the day, Vikaji, whether it's not the association you go by, it's a diaspora that's represented, right? Whether as, when you go to the stakeholders, it's really the community. They don't see whether you're from Punjabi or Malayali or Telugu. They see you as an Indian, and that's kind of what we represent. It doesn't matter how many are there, as long as we work together, that's the main thing.
Right. Okay. So aap sab logon ne jana ki 31 karib association hai jo FINACT ke saath hai, aur there are other allied association that works with FINACT to give voice to the Indian community diaspora. Cohesively we work, and then we provide, you know, what we provide and what is the fair which is coming up. We will know after this quick short break. Don't go anywhere. We will be right back. I am with Mr. Shanti Reddy, who is the president of FINACT, and you are listening to ACT Desi. ब्रेक पे जाने से पहले हमने जाना कि FINACT का क्या रोल है और कैसे वो एसोसिएशंस को जोड़ के रखता है और डायस्पोरा की एक आवाज जो सिंगल नहीं है लेकिन यूनाइटेड वॉइस है जो प्रेजेंट करते हैं ऑस्ट्रेलियन कम्युनिटी और यू नो ब्रॉडली इंडियन कम्युनिटी इन ऑस्ट्रेलिया इंडिया या एनीवेयर इन द वर्ल्ड. तो आज मेरे साथ हैं मिस्टर शांति रेड्डी और जैसे मैंने ब्रेक पे जाने से पहले बताया था कि अब हम बात करेंगे ऑज इंडिया फेयर की जो होने वाला है 2 अप्रैल को और क्या है उसमें खास और क्या आप एक्सपेक्ट कर सकते हैं. दैट इज सो जस्ट मिस्टर शांति रेड्डी जस्ट टेल अस व्हाट इज दिस इवेंट ऑल अबाउट एंड व्हाट कैन वी एक्सपेक्ट एज अ कैनबेरन फ्रॉम इंडिया नॉट फ्रॉम इंडिया एनीवेयर इन द वर्ल्ड. व्हाट कैन आई एक्सपेक्ट इन ऑज इंडिया फेयर. जस्ट गिव मी अ पिच.
थैंक यू विकास जी. सो ऑज इंडिया फेयर इज FINACT's फ्लैगशिप इवेंट. सो वी सेलिब्रेट, we bring communities together, we celebrate Australia-India friendship. People from all backgrounds are welcome. It's a free entry. We have fantastic events lined up for you. So there's a, we start the day with a yoga session. We have some fun sports, tug of war. We have harmony day celebrations now, right? And we have fantastic events lined up for harmony day. And we have kids activities. We have stalls, right? 35 stalls. You can come and shop.
Tell me about the stalls. Which all pavilions can we see? Which all Indian pavilions can we get in?
Yeah. That's a good question, right? So we have fashion clothing, right? We have people, some of the shops, they're bringing handmade ethnic wear from India, some remote parts of India.
Wow.
Very, very special. You won't find it anywhere. And these are, I would value them more than designer wear, right? So they have fashion clothing, and there's jewelry, all that sort of things. We have 8 or 9 of them, right? We have a food stall, so you can come and taste authentic Indian food.
When you say Indian food, I want people to specifically know some of the names, because when we say Indian food, somehow it just stays at one particular name, and I don't want to stay there. I want some particular name for people to know that, you know, you can get it from, say, this state, you can get it from this state, so that, you know, they get a variety of sense of variety that they can expect.
Yeah. So we have, for example, Kerala Cafe, they are there. So they will bring, they are bringing very authentic Kerala food. Aap jante hain Vikas ji, there's a quite a range of delicacies from Kerala. Right. And I know we have Dosha Hut will be there. They bring the dosas, as the name implies, and we have Seven Hills, a wonderful, a delicious food from southern India. And then we have chai, and what we call chai and chat.
Masala chai,
and the chat, that group is coming. Mr. Patel, he will be there as well. So we will, you can see they're all very authentic Indian food, but also you'll have that atmosphere, carnival atmosphere. So you come out with, you know, family, friends, kids. As I said, there are plenty of kids activities there, rides, you know, there's slides. Some of them, you know, you will see, you would have seen in the Royal Canberra show. So we've actually got that amusement from the company. So
on a serious note, yes. what do you think a fair like this, AusIndia Fair, what does it brings to Australia and India as countries? And what is the exchange here? What is the, you know, end game? Or say, for example, what is that we are trying to achieve? Like, if you have to say one line about what do you want to achieve with this?
We want to have people to have fun. We want people to perform, because a lot of these talented people have lacked that opportunity to express. You know, you know, Vikaji, you are in this radio show. It's a form of expression for you. So there are people who are singers, instrumental musicians, dancers. All of them have been really, didn't get the opportunity to perform. So our goal really is to give them an opportunity. And also, we have missed this social interaction. It is such a critical thing for Indian diaspora, but also everyone, to come and actually have that interaction. So we are fortunate to have that after 2 years of, lockdowns and other restrictions. We're unable to showcase this and many other events. So to me, in one line, it's all about come and have fun, enjoy the cultural performances, clapping those things. Those artists will feel such a great thing, right? It's all that you're catering to that inner creativity. Right. This is very important for well-being, because, as you know very well, you know, we all can work remotely and get that, you know, your salary coming in. But that's not all of it. Right. Mm-hmm. You need to go and do this sort of a creative side of your brain that you need to let it go. So this is opportunity. So to me, that's really important. But there's a bigger picture, too. It's also showcasing the Indian diaspora, the contribution to the economy. You know, you come and see the businesses. I was saying, you know, 20 years ago, you would have dreamt that. You couldn't see any of that, whereas now you can see this enterprising nature of the Indian community diaspora. So to me, it's a showcasing that and showcasing the relations. You know, there will be High Commissioner will be there, but also the senior ministers and other people from here.
Correct. So aapne jo itna sara mujhe ab bata diya hai ki ye sab hone wala hai. I am very excited, and I'm hopefully thinking that whosoever is listening or watching this is getting excited as well. So, ab aapne ye sab to bata diya, but ye kahan pe aur kitne baje hone wala, ye to abhi tak aapne bataya nahi. To wo bataiye taki hum is show ko ek high note pe close kar paye, aur people would know where to come, you know, on Saturday and enjoy this.
Thank you. Number one, Randwick Road, Lynham, ACT. Just Google for Thoroughbred Park, which is a race course. There's only one race course in Canberra, in Mitchell or Lynham, in between Mitchell and Lynham. That's where the show is happening. It's a very beautiful ground. There's a plenty of space for kids to run around. There's a lot of lawns and beautiful shaded areas. And it's covered area. Even if it rains, we don't have to worry. It's the whole building is covered. We'll be inside. And it has a capacity for 2,000 people. So, yeah, we look forward to seeing many of you, your listeners. Vikas ji, aap bhi aayega, aap hamare special mehman aayega.
Aur sir, ye aapne bas ek cheez reh gayi, kab se leke kab tak, kab shuru hoga aur kab khatam hoga, ye nahi bataya aapne.
Haan, bilkul sahi hai. Haan, ye 12 baje shuru hoga ekdam yoga session ke saath, sharp 12 o'clock and finish at 6 o'clock with a big bang Bollywood dance. Don't miss the last part of the 5 o'clock jo finish honge cultural programs. Then 5 to 6 we have DJ. So 12 to 6 o'clock.
Right. So 12 se 6 baje Lynham mein Thoroughbred Park mein agar aapko isolation jo aapka kehte hain na self isolation hai usse bahar nikalna hai kaam se kuch thoda sa free hona hai aur kuch enjoy karna hai fun karna jaise Shanti ji ne bola to aapke paas sirf ek hi location hai Saturday ko aane ke liye aur wo hai AusIndia Fair jo ho raha hai 2nd April yani ki Saturday ko aur 12 baje shuru hoga yoga ke sath aur khatam bhi hoga exercise ke sath lekin wo exercise hogi thodi डांस वाली तो जरूर आइएगा और थैंक यू फॉर योर कंपनी टुडे यू बीन सो काइंड एंड शेयर्ड ऑल दोस थिंग्स विद मी ऑडियंस जो आपने सुना आपको भी शायद ये पसंद आया होगा और ऐसे ही अगर आप कुछ और चीज सुनना चाहते हैं कनेक्ट करना चाहते हैं मेरे साथ कुछ एक शो पे लाना चाहते हैं कुछ टॉपिक्स को तो प्लीज रीच आउट टू मी थ्रू माई फेसबुक पेज विच इज ACT Desi FM या आप मुझसे मेरे ईमेल के थ्रू भी जुड़ सकते हैं जो कि है info@content-artist.com तो जब तक हम मिलते हैं दोबारा अपना ख्याल रखिएगा शुभ रात्रि शबा खैर गुड नाइट
விட்டு தம்மு தம்மு கட்டுக்கிட்டு துள்ளித்தான் காய்க்கா நாட்டு கூத்த காட்டு